So kind. Good morning, Mount Hope United Church of Christ. Good morning, friends, community, family. We're so glad that you could join us for worship here this morning. This is Good Shepherd Sunday, the Sunday that we remember Jesus as our Good Shepherd. Before we move any forward, I want to encourage you to write any comments that you have down below. Certainly, if you have any prayer requests, we would ask that you would submit those so that we might know how to best pray for you and others in your life this week. We have been encouraged to pray for Cole Yedlowski. He has a brain tumor and is getting ready to undergo treatment for that. We also are praying for Gloria's healing, Debbie and Tracy and Tracy. Harrison, Hardin, and Kimberly Ward, for all of those at all of the nursing care facilities, but especially CLAPS and Alamance and Universal Healthcare. If you can see up at our altar and at the butterfly cross, our youth have made signs for those who are on the front line of caring for us. So thank you, youth, for your prayers, especially this week for those who are in healthcare, those who are doctors, nurses, CNAs, janitors, all of those who are on the front lines of taking care of those who are sick. So thank you. Take just a look and see at all the good work that's been done. We're going to be putting these out at the nursing care facilities to be a sign of encouragement and a sign of hope as folks move through this coming week. We are also praying for Doug Clapp's mother-in-law who fell and broke her hip and surgery is pending. Is there anyone else that we should pray for on your heart today? Remember his first name? Reverend Ship was what I William. Yes. Joan's grandfather had a stroke this week, is still in the hospital making some recovery, and we are grateful for that, but we pray for William Ship and his family. Anyone else?
Wes.
Continued prayers for Jeff. Let us go to God in the spirit of prayer. Oh God, today as we remember that this is Good Shepherd Sunday, we are thankful for you, for your willingness to hear our voices calling on you in prayer. And long before that, we are thankful that you once knew us and formed us and placed us in our mother's womb for us to be born into this world at this time for such things as these. And that we could walk this earth with a spark of your truth and goodness and light and love in our lives that others might join us in knowing you more clearly. We thank you for all of that, and even while we have been living our lives, you have been holding us and caring for us and tending to us just like a good shepherd. So we are eternally grateful for all of those ways that you continue to be present in our lives, including right now, when we call on your name and know without a shadow of a doubt that you hear us, that you join with us, that you hold us, and bring us your mercy and promise. On this particular day, O Lord, you have heard the prayers of your people. You have heard us call out those children by name whom we know need a special portion of your grace and healing mercy. So we ask, O Lord, for prayers for all of them, for those who are from Psalm 23. I read it today from the Message. It's a Bible translation in contemporary language by Eugene Peterson. God, my my shepherd, I don't need a thing. You have bedded me down in lush meadows, you find me quiet pools to drink from. True to your word, you let me catch my breath and send me in the right direction. Even when the way goes through Death Valley, I'm not afraid when you are by my side. Your trusty shepherd's crook makes me feel secure. You serve me a 6-course dinner right in front of my enemies. You revive my drooping head. My cup brims with blessing. Your beauty and love chase after me every day of my life. I'm back home in the house of God for the rest of my life. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Today we talk about Good Shepherd Sunday. Does anyone know a shepherd? I asked to the congregation I was serving before I began the sermon on Good Shepherd Sunday. I do, came a faint voice from a place in the congregation from which I was not expecting to hear anything. The sound was coming from a member of the congregation who was often quiet and sat in the same spot every Sunday. I knew this man to be smart and funny and thoughtful and generous, but I didn't know that he knew a shepherd. I stepped down out of the pulpit, expecting that if he knew a shepherd, the sermon I had written during the week just might need to wait for a different time. That God might be calling us to do a different thing right there on the spot. So addressing the member of my flock, I said, "You know a shepherd?" "Sure do," he said. "She's right there." He pointed his finger down the pew and I followed the trail until my eyes landed on one of the older members of the congregation, Miss Shepherd. It was a great way to open a sermon, but it wasn't exactly the type of shepherd I was talking about on Good Shepherd Sunday. So do you know a shepherd? Maybe you know someone whose last name is a shepherd, but do you know a shepherd? Someone who tends to the sheep. Well, the shepherds that I believe influenced the psalmist and Jesus calling himself the Good Shepherd, who lays down his life for his sheep, you have to know a little bit about how the sheep were tended in those days. Oftentimes, the dwelling for the sheep was built off of the dwelling house, and it had enclosures on all sides but one. And the shepherd's job was when it was time for the flock to come home to bed down for the evening, the sheep went to sleep. It was the shepherd's job to sit over or lay down over the entrance to the fold going into the sheep so that the sheep would be safe, and if something tried to enter into the sheep to harm them or hurt them, the shepherd would know it because they would have to step over the shepherd first. There's a few other things about the shepherd you might want to know. Well, let's start with the sheep. You see, there's been many times when people said the sheep were just those dumb farm animals. And they thought they must be dumb because sheep had to follow something, had to follow someone. Somebody had to take care of the sheep. There are other herds who don't need to be taken care of, but the sheep often do. And so they thought for that reason that sheep were dumb. That is not true. Sheep are smart. And here's how I know that. Because scientists have proven that shepherds can remember the faces of 100 people at one time. Sheep can remember. They have shown them pictures and had people live in front of them, taken them away for 2 years, and brought them back, and they remember them. They can tell by the way they bleat and by the way that they respond to the people who have once been in their lives. That's pretty smart, if you ask me. And here's why that is so smart. Because the sheep know what it is to be in relationship with the shepherd. The shepherd not only lays down his life in front of the door of the sheep pen so that they might be safe at night, but the shepherd, after all day of being out in the field, when it's time to come in, the shepherd holds out his shepherd's crook, calls their name, and the sheep know their names. They know what it sounds like for the shepherd to call them by name, and they respond. Don't believe me? Look up shepherd calling sheep on YouTube. There are some phenomenal videos. The sheep hear the familiar voice of the shepherd. They come running, and the shepherd holds out the shepherd's crook, not just for pulling them back from a cliff before they fall, but he holds it up like it is an x-ray machine, and the sheep walk under it once every night. And it is at that moment that the shepherd takes inventory of that sheep. Did it sustain any injuries during the day? And if so, that is a time to give them the care that they need before going to bed. There is a relationship that is built between the shepherd and the sheep. See, sheep are smart after all, aren't they? And the relationship that the shepherd and the sheep bind together, the way in which they bond, is never more evident than in the 23rd Psalm. I wanted to read it to you in a different version. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. You see, when the sheep are with the shepherd, they want for nothing. They have everything that they need. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. What else could a sheep need but green grass and cool, fresh water to drink? But the shepherd doesn't stop there. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. And even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. So if you stop and look at how this psalmist wrote the structure of this psalm, we begin to understand what is at the very heart of the psalmist and what is at the very heart of the relationship between the sheep and the shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths. But when I walk through that darkest valley, you are with me. The psalmist knows at the very center of this psalm, the truth emerges. The psalmist's heart flourishes because the truth is here. The psalmist is not talking about God as if God is somewhere else. That's how you refer to somebody when they are not with you. He does this. She does that. But in the center of this psalm, the one thing that everything else revolves around is that when the sheep truly need the shepherd, you are with me. Right now, in the person, in the present, right here with me. The shepherd goes on to do many more great things, like preparing a table before my enemies and my cup running over with blessings. But all of that can only happen when the sheep know the shepherd and know that the shepherd desires to be in relationship with the sheep. It's interesting how all of these scriptures that we are reading now in this time of COVID-19, we have read before. They are familiar stories, both out of the Psalms, out of John's Gospel and Luke's Gospel, that have been informing our worship the past 8 weeks. But they are so poignantly true and helpful during these times. Which one of us doesn't need to rely on a shepherd? Which one of us doesn't need to be taken care of right now? Which one of us doesn't need a little patch of green grass to hang out in and a big cold cup of water to quench our thirst right now? I think if this scripture had been written during the COVID-19 days, there would have been somewhere in here that said, "My shepherd even gives me a hug when I need it most." And that probably could be about all of us right now. But during these COVID-19 times, which one of us doesn't need to know a shepherd? And not just someone with the last name, but the shepherd who has promised to be with us in all of these times, especially when we need them most. Even though I walk through the darkest valleys, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod, you know that rod that Moses held up and struck the rock, and the very rock poured out water for the people in the middle of the desert? It is a rod similar to that that our shepherd promises to be with us through. And this staff that comforts our wounds in the evenings. It is that rod and that staff that brings us comfort and peace, that provides for our needs even in our darkest times. It is in those kinds of promises that our shepherd promises to be the one who will lay down his life for his sheep. Wherever you are on this journey of life today, I pray that you know the shepherd, and that even if you know the shepherd, that you are using these times to know the shepherd even more. Can you hear him calling your name? Can you hear it? Go to him. In the name of our God who creates us, redeems us, sustains us, and hopes always for our wholeness. Amen. The church has had great opportunities this week to be the shepherd for those in our community. Grateful for those opportunities. I wish that you could be here so that you could be in the details of helping to work that out. It really has been an amazing week. I continue to ask for your prayers as the ministry of Mount Hope continues to stay strong. For we have said from the beginning on that March 15th day when we could not meet together and knew that this was going to be a while, that this was no time for the church to be absent, but a time for the church to be present in people's lives. Thank you for helping us do that. Thank you for your generosity. Thank you for your prayers and your financial gifts. Thank you for being with the church. The sheep and the shepherd are always together in those ways. There are multiple ways to give, as always, and if you need to be connected to those, please let us know. We'll be glad to help you. You're always welcome to mail a check. And on the website for Mount Hope Church, mthopeucc.com, you will find an online giving opportunity there should you need it. Again, we thank you for your generosity and for your giving. And this is why we give. Because when we are able to share what we have, we are less likely to turn inward on ourselves, but to continue to be a sheep that can surrender care to the shepherd and to be a shepherd to other sheep who need some care. That's why we give, and I thank you for participating in your faith in such a way.
We have a final song. The message of which, and the title of which, is Bind Us Together. We are still bound together in the love of Christ, even though we are not together physically.
Bind us together.
knowing that it is with God's grace that you were brought into the world. No, it is with the shepherd's love that you remain here. And that as you go out into the world and to your various places, that you are going with the gift of the Holy Spirit, who will bind us together with cords that cannot be broken until we are brought back together again. This week, listen, for the shepherd is calling your name. Come, running. God is waiting.